In this video, I want to talk about sponging and burnishing. Stampin' Up! Has some great tools for doing both of these techniques. They've got the sponge daubers, so you can save one for each of your individual colors, and they also have sponges. These sponges come as packs of three in large rounds. I cut them into quarters just so that I can get a better hold on them when I'm holding them like that. So that's a great tip to just cut them into quarters before you use them. First, let's talk about sponging. Sponging is probably something that we're all used to. We use it to sponge edges. You can use it to add color to the cardstock. So you pick up some ink and you just sponge it onto your paper. You can do the same thing with your daubers as well. So you can use your daubers and add color as well. You can also add color directly to the top as well as the edges. And to do this, you just pick up some color and tap lightly onto the cardstock until it's the color that you're looking for. So that's really it when it talks about sponging. Let's talk about burnishing now. Burnishing is a different technique, and it's something that I like to use to add color to projects. Here I've taken some glossy white cardstock and I've stamped my images on it. It doesn't need to be glossy. You can use any cardstock for this technique. And now we're going to burnish it. And burnishing, it is very similar to sponging, but a little bit different. So once you've picked up your color, you're going to make contact with your cardstock, but you're not going to tap. You're going to maintain that contact. So just go ahead. We're going to do the edges on this one, add some color to it. And you can see how burnishing gives it a different look. So if you do the typical sponging, you're going to get that sponge look to this. By burnishing instead, we get a different look. It's a look that's much more consistent, much flatter, and it just has the look that we're wanting. I like to use my lightest color last, just to go over it, fill in any spaces that are left. And again, when we're burnishing, you make constant contact. You're not tapping. You're making that constant contact onto your cardstock. Keep going until all of the white spots are filled in. There you go. Give it just a second to dry. If you have done it over anything that's embossed, you're going to want to take a tissue and go over the top to clean up that embossing look. But that's it. That's the technique that we use for burnishing. And here's a finished card that I've made with that technique. So you can see it's a great way to add color to cardstock. Very vibrant, but you don't get the sponge look. You get a really consistent look on top of your cardstock. Thanks for watching.